No. The place is full of nothing but blood and death.
Can someone please tell me what the hell is going on here?
Well, well, Ethan Winters.
What the hell was that?
Let's see what you're really made of. Ethan Winters.
Hey everyone, and welcome to the second Resident Evil Showcase. I'm your host, Brittany Brombacher, and I am so excited to be your guide through today's experience. We're going to hear from the Resident Evil team today, and they have so much new content for you.
So much.
Trailer, new gameplay, and more news for Resident Evil Village, which is right around the corner, coming to us on May 7th.
Yes.
Also be sharing the latest on the 25th anniversary of the series, and some fun surprises that go along with that, so stay tuned. To kick us off,
give me all the goods.
Yuji, the executive producer of the franchise.
Hi, I'm Jun Takeuchi, executive producer on Resident Evil. Due to your continued support, the franchise has reached its 25th anniversary. Thank you so much.
At 25th.
Whole years, supported by so many of our fans. When I look back over the years and think about when we first started this project with Shinji Mikami, I never would have imagined that it would turn into such a long-lasting franchise. Even now, I want to see the series continue to succeed through your continued support. Now we've prepared the latest trailer for our upcoming title, Resident Evil Village. It's a game jam-packed full of entertainment and horror, and it has a huge breadth of content, so brace yourselves when you play.
Oh boy.
Without further ado, please enjoy.
Here we go. Let's see this. World premiere.
Midnight moon rises on black wings. We await the light at the end. In life and in death, glory to Mother Miranda.
Umbrella? The heck?
Bet you're whining. We're almost there.
Where are you?
Hello. If there are any survivors out there, come to my... to Louisa's house near the fields.
Long, long ago.
Oh no! They're coming.
Oh crap, there's gonna be a section like that.
Mother Miranda has always protected.
Oh crap.
Brothers, idiot games, did you?
Jesus Christ. And then you feed her your blood, what the heck?
That's all that's left from your entire village?
All that's left? There is no one left! We can bust out with this.
Oh, shoot.
Icons and gentlemen, we thank you for waiting. And now let the games begin.
There is no safe. Every sorry bastard out there has been ripped in half.
Tomorrow. Man, what in the world? This game looks huge. Kinda seems like they're gonna give Ethan Winters more development on this.
Get off of me!
Stay the fuck down!
I gotta say, I'm surprised you made it this far. It'd be a shame if something happened to you now.
You killed Mia. Now do me and finish the job.
Oh, he killed Mia? Oh, shoot. Chris is gonna turn to a werewolf. at some point.
There's so much to break down there. I know we cannot wait to find out what.
But man, but why is Chris doing all this though?
Another demo was coming this spring. Something tells me.
Oh, another demo. Okay.
With Lady Dimitrescu, but I don't think the internet would mind that. Let's pass it to.
See, even they're aware. See, even they're aware of that. Oh my God.
Upcoming gameplay demo. Kanda-san, thank you so much for joining us again today.
Oh yeah, I am waiting for it too. Let's.
Thank you for the introduction, Brittany. Hi everyone, I'm Tsuyoshi Kanda, producer on Resident Evil Village. Resident Evil Village has been created with the concept of a beautiful yet terrifying village in mind. And we have poured our passion into creating this experience for our fans.
Yeah, it kind of gives me RE4 vibes at times, which I freaking love.
Management and horror elements you expect from Resident Evil. We've also made sure there's plenty of gameplay content as well. In the previous showcase, we told you that we'd have another demo ready for you across multiple platforms.
Well, kind of wish they didn't show that Chris freaking killed Mia. I kind of wish they didn't show that.
PlayStation 4, Xbox Series X, Xbox One, Steam, and Stadia. In lieu of the game event that
PS5 for me.
We have prepared a special day where you can experience Resident Evil Village.
Okay.
Here are the details on what it will be available.
A time limit. Play up to 60, play May 1st, 5 PM, whatever. Ugh, damn.
The village and castle areas.
So 60 minutes.
You're free to spend one full hour for both stages.
That's way more than when they did the RE2 demo.
It's up to you while you spend your survivor horror experience. PlayStation 5 and PlayStation 4 owners will also
early access.
As well. We've titled it 8 Hours in Village.
8 hours? What?
We have the details for you here.
Oh, okay. 30 minutes of the castle. Okay, I was about to say, like, wait, what?
Installment of the franchise. You will have an 8-hour window to try out the demo for 30 minutes.
Okay.
PlayStation players will have early access to the village section first, followed by the castle section. For the early access players, feel free to also stream and share your playthrough to the world.
I'll definitely do that.
We hope that with your help, we will be able to show off the demo to everyone. And for the multiple
platforms, although I hope my work schedule isn't gonna affect it.
All over the world will be able to enjoy the Resident Evil Village demo. Finally, players will be able to pre-order the demo ahead of time.
Okay.
PlayStation 5 and PlayStation 4 owners are able to pre-download the demo starting today.
Nice, okay. I'll get on that.
Please visit our official website for more details. We hope you enjoy this upcoming sneak peek at the next generation of survivor horror.
That's around.
I'm so torn where to spend my time. Do I spend it in the village or the castle? Let us know what your plan is. But in the meantime, what if
definitely
I
definitely the village? Because I already sort of kind of ish got a taste.
Let's
of the castle in the first demo.
Sato to tell us what he knows.
They was definitely on point with the atmosphere on this, because goodness gracious.
Hi, everyone. I'm Director Morimasa Sato.
Chris and Smat, nah.
All about the much requested extra game mode included with Resident Evil Village, the mercenaries.
For those of you, although it'd be funny time, if they did happen to put them in there, they'll make a bolder joke from 5.
Arcade style action, where you have to reach the goal within a certain time limit.
I mean, I might be a bit biased since I would like to see Leon since he's my favorite, but. But I know Chris was like the OG since way back in the first game.
The first change is that we've added a shop. In this version of the Mercenaries, you can access the Duke's Emporium between areas.
Now this is cool. As I'm saying, this is so many RE4 vibes, and I love it.
I saw you eyeing that one. Weapons modifications, and we'll do.
Thank you for your patronage.
Guard. Yes, I love that they brought something like this back.
Expect this side mode to be just as fast-paced as the previous installments.
Cause they had something like this in 7, but it wasn't. It was not mercenaries.
You'll have to consider which weapons you'll take into each stage and how to customize them. With a large arsenal of options,
and I'll definitely be having fun on this.
What strategy works best for them? Another change is the addition of abilities. Abilities can increase the damage of handguns.
Yeah, this one looks to have a lot of enemy variety. Cause that was one of the main issues with 7, was just the lack of enemy variety. Cause you literally just had different versions of the molded, which they were cool, but there wasn't really like a lot of different ones. Because I will be streaming a revisit of RE7 before 8 comes out. I'll probably do that on the VR.
If you're looking for an additional challenge, we hope you're excited for this extra mode that's included with the main game.
I'll definitely check it out.
It's a challenging and rewarding bonus mode packed with content, so we hope everyone is looking forward to it. Thank you so much for watching.
If you haven't already heard, Resident Evil has reached an impressive milestone. On March 22nd, the franchise celebrated its 25th anniversary. And like so many of you, I've been a fan since practically day one. Together, we've
For me, it was since 5.
Of survival horror games,
I mean, I've watched my dad play like 2 and 4 for a bit, but 5 was like the first one I played and got into the series and started to play the older ones.
Lots of you probably tried the open beta earlier this month, but don't forget, Resident Evil RE:Verse will be available for free to anyone who purchases Resident Evil Village. The franchise has also inspired change and evolution in the video game industry as a whole. Let's hear from some industry powerhouses here to celebrate the 25th anniversary of the Resident Evil franchise.
It's crazy how different this whole series has throughout the years.
I'd like to congratulate the Resident Evil team on their 25th. 25 years is a long time. It's been a true pleasure watching Capcom embrace new technologies and find new ways to advance storytelling and gameplay over the last 4 console generations. And I can't wait to see what Resident Evil Village will be like on PlayStation 5.
Biohazard 25周年, おめでとうございます。 Bio 1 が出た時, 初代 PlayStation の売り上げがバーンと伸びたのを思い出します。
本当嬉しかったです。そしてバイオ7ではPS VRで新しい体験を届けていただきました。 I feel like they're gonna save for the second PlayStation VR for them to add a VR support for RE8 because RE7's VR was still freaking great.
Art director at Naughty Dog. I wanted to first congratulate all of the developers for 25 years of amazing Resident Evil titles. I hope that no matter what game you touched or what part of the game you're responsible for, you've brought inspiration to so many people over the years, myself included. So thanks so much, guys, and again, congratulations.
Hello, my name is Siobhan Reddy, and I am the studio director at Media Molecule.
This is already better than how Mario. I mean, this is already better than how Nintendo treated Mario's 35th anniversary.
With your incredible franchise, I hope you're super proud of yourselves.
And that's really sad.
You know, really enjoying kind of seeing, you know, seeing how your beloved franchise has sort of developed over these last 25 years. It's awesome. So huge congratulations to all of you.
Infinite Darkness. Oh, wait a minute.
Hi, everyone. I'm here.
Yeah, this is that Yeah, this is that entertainment anime or movie that's coming on Netflix. This year
marks the 25th anniversary of the series.
I can't remember.
I worked as a programmer on the first title and as producer on several titles over the years. It's amazing to see how far the franchise has come. It's a brand name that you hear even in the movie business, and it's thanks to the love and support from the fans. To all of you, thank you so much. Now, we have something new to show you today from one of our latest projects. Please sit back and enjoy.
Sit back, people. Another storm is coming.
Never gotten clearance to land that fast before. You must be special.
Okay, yeah, this is the... This is that one that's coming on Netflix.
Get anyone to go on record. Doesn't that look a lot like Raccoon City?
Oh boy.
I gotta go. Don't do anything stupid.
Hey Leon, that outfit doesn't suit you.
Okay, it's anime. Okay.
Let's get the president to the bunker.
I don't know who's gonna be willing to watch it with me, but July, okay.
What did you think?
I'll definitely be in on that.
Able to share the latest trailer for Resident Evil Infinite Darkness with you today, starring Leon and Claire. It takes place in 2006.
Oh god, years. Oh god, after 4. Okay.
A zombie outbreak is happening in the White House, and the president is none other than the father of Ashley Graham from Resident Evil 4.
Okay.
He's just one of the many characters that
Before 6 when he got killed.
Resident Evil Infinite Darkness will be airing on Netflix worldwide in July 2021.
Can't wait.
I have one more announcement for you.
Oh shoot!
Reboot of Resident Evil. Filming in Toronto has wrapped up, and we're in the middle of creating the creatures in CGI. So please.
This I really want to see more of.
The release date. Thank you for watching.
Cause my only worry I have right now is just they're probably cramming in too much. But it does seem like they care so much for the series, so it's like. What the? Oh my god!
Hi.
Don't tell me y'all gonna get me to play that just for that.
Congratulations on 25 years of.
Oh, dang it.
Over the years, our very own 4v1 multiplayer action game, Dead by Daylight, has become the Hall of Fame of horror. And today, I'm excited to say Resident Evil will soon be joining our universe.
Y'all really try to get me the fold into playing this now. God dang it.
The 25th, for the full reveal of the Resident Evil chapter coming to DBD this June. And in the meantime, if you're up for it, I suggest you get some time before the chapter comes into the fog. Because look, you have two choices here. Kill or be killed. It's your call.
Oh my freaking god.
Well, we're not quite finished yet. Here's one more announcement that's taking Resident Evil to a brand new...
One more announcement?
Let's take a look.
Oh jeez. Alright, what you got cooking up? Oh shoot! Ah.
I'm Mike Morishita, executive producer at Facebook.
Ah, I was hoping it was PlayStation VR.
The franchise that changed the way we think about video games is still going strong after 25 years. Congratulations, Capcom, on this incredible milestone.
Yeah, I said it.
Now let's rewind for a moment. I remember when Resident Evil 4 launched in 2005.
What are y'all doing?
It was amazing.
What are y'all doing?
Nobody had ever seen a game like it before. And it remains at the pinnacle. The survival horror genre.
What are y'all doing?
In the 16 years since the launch of Resident Evil 4, the gaming industry has evolved, and new ways to play have entered the market. And we've been eager to explore how Resident Evil 4 can could be
enhanced. No, don't tell me I had a VR support for this.
I'm Mike Verdue.
Do not freaking tell me.
Reality Labs. I'm excited to announce that Capcom, Oculus Studios, and Arm.
Oh my god!
Evil 4 to Quest 2. We're thrilled about this game.
Why not PlayStation VR?
The world of Resident
Evil. Oh, come on!
It's immersive, comes with a first-person perspective, and will bring new richness and depth to the Resident Evil 4 experience you know and love.
Man!
For the first time. Tune in to the Oculus Gaming
Show. Man!
The 21st. For more details on
Resident Evil 4. Sucks!
How we brought this title to this new medium.
You gotta be freaking kidding me, man.
On the Oculus Facebook page or on Twitch.
My father?
Man. Still awake. Oh, God, playing on PlayStation VR, dang it. Oh, that sucks. I would love to play that.
Let's recap the exciting news from today's event.
Damn it, man.
This is on May 7th, and a demo experience will be available for a limited
time. See, like, I would fold, but I ain't paying all that money just to play that. Today.
The Mercenaries mode was also announced for the first look at
game. Man.
This fan favorite will be included with the game. And finally, to celebrate 25 years of the franchise, we have Resident Evil Infinite Darkness coming to Netflix. And new upcoming collaborations with partners outside of Capcom. Thanks again for spending some time with us today for another exciting showcase. I'm your host, Brittany Brombacher, and it's been an honor being here with you again and hosting this event. Have a great day.
Man.
Bye bye.
God dang it.
Another time.
Oh my god. What a way to close it. Once again, they did a much better job of showcasing their anniversary with their own franchise than Nintendo did with Mario. Because at least they're showing that they actually care. So, we got the game coming out, got freaking them coming on Dead by Daylight, which, God, I may need to fold on that, and then you got the anime coming out on Netflix, which I'll definitely be watching that, because I definitely do enjoy the animated movies, even though Vendetta was, like, probably one of the most over-the-top things I've ever seen, but I enjoyed it. And then y'all had the nerve to have RE4 in VR, but only on the ones that I don't have. I hope they'll actually put it on the PlayStation VR, especially how 7 originally was on there. Like, come on, man. Y'all can do it. Oh man, what a day. Alright. Well, I guess I'm gonna go ahead and go, guys. I'll definitely be streaming those demos when those come out. Hopefully my work schedule ain't gonna affect or anything. But I bet I'll have a good time when those comes. But yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and go, guys. Thanks for coming by, everybody. Hope y'all enjoyed it, and I'll see y'all later. Have a good night. Bye.